Sam and Bill. And our project is called the Car Seat Black Box. And it was to create a car seat monitoring system. And so pretty much we were one of two teams that were assigned this project. And it was to create a car seat monitoring system that would record the amount of time a baby would spend in a car seat. And the reason this was needed was our customer, Michelle DeGrazia, was doing a study to see how much time, to correlate the effects with how much time a baby spends in the car seat and any health problems that would arise. Because children or small infants have very malleable heads, so if they're positioned poorly in a car seat, it can cause health problems such as breathing problems and brain damage. So by being able to record the amount of time they spend in the car seat, it should be able to do a record on the product. On the problem. So our solution to the problem was to create a portable monitoring system. We would use an array of micro switches on a pad to detect the infant and use a microprocessor to record the amount of time that a baby spends in this machine. And in order to, this would all be done in a portable device, and the device would then be able to connect to a PC to download the data through USB to a file that can be saved on a PC. So the specifications for our project were to record a timestamp when the baby was first put in the seat and when they would be removed, to create a portable device that would operate on batteries, and we were able to operate, get our device with two AA batteries, and it, we found that, calculated that our device would last for about 11 weeks, so a little over 2 months. And our customers specified that 2 months would be the minimum time period, so we met that criteria. And in order to, like I said, to transfer the data to a PC, we would be doing it through USB, because USB is present on every computer, so it would be easy and quite to use. And we record the data on non-volatile EEPROM memory, so that means that it would not be erased in case the device is turned off or something goes wrong and malfunction would be stored on the in the memory. And after the 2 month trial period, our device has an audible alert to signal the user to return the device to our customer, Michelle DeGrazia, to switch the batteries out, because our device is not supposed to be supposed to be unobtrusive and not interfere with the daily lives of the patients or the parents of the infants. And now Mike can take you through a system block diagram. So this is our product, by the way. It's the pad in the background you can see is our sensing pad. It's an array of micro switches inside of there. It's connected with a ribbon cable to our black box device, which has two status LEDs, which pretty much that's just for our purposes, because once this is integrated into the car seat, it would be it was supposed to be invisible pretty much. So and then the USB to connect to the system.
This is our system block diagram. Our device, we have 5-pin module, which is a microcontroller, sensor module, power supply, memory module, and the information module. And the sensor module is our sensor pad, which consists of an array of micro switches, the power supply is the 2 AA batteries. Our memory module is the EEPROM for flash memory. The information module consists of the status LEDs and buzzer. Over to the user that is on the trap, so she turned the device back to the user. Our launch modules, our main module would be the microcontroller, the MC9S0060. We chose this microcontroller for our device because of its USB functionality and its I2C to communicate flash memory. And to transfer data over to the PC, the microcontroller first streams the data from the WECOM by I2C bus, and we then transfer the data to the USB to the user's PC. Our device stores the number of sessions and the global time in the WEPROM, so that upon reset, our device will not erase all the number of sessions and the global time, or retain its values by retrieving the data back from the WEPROM. And it checks the activity of the sensor every 20 seconds, the presence of the infant. And while it's not checking the activity of the sensors, we'll go to sleep mode to lessen our devices. Power consumption. And the presence of the infant must last at least 1 minute before the device is considered as a valid session. If it's less than a minute, then the device will just disregard the data and wait for the presence of the infant again. And if it is considered a valid session, In the absence of the input lasted at least 1 minute, it will store the time of the session to the WEPROM. Our device receives functions independently from the user interaction, aside from setting up the device on the car seat and retrieving the data back from the device. And the three status LEDs on our device indicates the operation status, when the detection of the input and storing the session to memory. And the USB port is used to allow the user to communicate with our device and connect our device to a graphic user interface that we created. And the graphic user interface allows the user to download and erase the data from our device. And also allows the user an option to save download data to a viewable.csv file format, which is compatible with Microsoft Excel. And also has the ability to save the CPU, the PC's clock, to our device, which allows an accurate timestamp for every session recorded to the EEPROM.
So I'm going to talk about the technology we use to create our device. First, we mentioned we're using the MC9S or the AM65 controller. For our microswitches, we're using a Panasonic DQ push button microswitch. And our EEPROM flash memory is the M24C16. It's 512 kilobytes, which turns out to be 64 kilobytes. And we're using AA batteries to power our device. Some of the development tools we're using is Visual Studio for writing the code for our GUI. Code Warrior is used to program our microcontroller. We've also purchased a demonstration board that we could develop code, test, and debug our device before actually creating a working PCB. Altium Designer was used finally to create a working PCB for our device. Now we're going to talk about the graphic user interface. The development of the graphic user interface was done using C Sharp. It's done in conjunction with a USB library that defines the USB protocol that we're using to transmit data from the PC to the device and vice versa. The functionality of the GUI, it can transfer data and receive data from the PC of the user to the device. The user has the option to create a .csv file after downloading all the data on the WEPROM. That's a picture of our GUI on the right. I'm going to talk a little bit about the buttons and the connect device does simply that. It connects the device to the GUI once it's connected to USB. The sync button transfers over the PC time to our device, allowing us to have an accurate timestamp. Download data and erase data are both transfer and receive. They do that using the USB protocol. And these message windows relay messages to the user about what data is transmitted there and the status of command sent to the user. They also have the option of saving the file to a .csv file.
So I'm going to talk a little bit about our PCB and how we designed it. So we designed the PCB using LTL Designer. And as you can see, this is our schematic. Our microcontroller is it's pretty much the heart of our project. We performed a worst-case scenario analysis and determined that 7 kilobytes of memory was needed for our 4-month study. So the microcontroller has 8 kilobytes of onboard RAM. So for this module, here's our 64 kilobyte WEPROM memory. It communicates to the microcontroller via the I2C bus line, which is essentially the flat line and the data line. Making use of the many GPU